My dear Minfilia, unpleasant though it will be for all concerned, you leave us no choice but to employ more rigorous methods of study. Be so kind as to deliver the prisoners to Castrum Meridiani.
Yes, milady!
I know not which is more pitiful, the charlatans who rule Eorzea, or the masses that clamor for their implausible panaceas. I see that which they cannot. This realm founders for want of a ruler with true power. The power to cast down icons. If you continue to deny this truth, it is the people who will suffer. Embrace reason.
What in the seven hells? Oh no, it's here.
12 preservas, they finished it. Ultima weapon.
So it has a name.
It is a relic of ancient Alag. Excavated from its resting place deep beneath Alamigo. The Alagans used it to crush primal and foe alike, and now the Galleons mean to do the same.
Damn you, Gaius! Look! There, beside the Black Wolf! An Ascian! An Overlord, no less. His garb attests to that.
La Habrea. It could only be him. Thancred! Was La Habrea? No. No, this cannot be!
Small wonder the enemy knew our every move.
We have to go now! Hang on!
Thancred! No!
I've never been one to shy from a fight, but if this weapon of theirs can do all they claim...
Van Belsar's demands are clear.
It has been 5 years since the Calamity, and our people have scarce begun to rebuild their lives. Can we now, in good conscience, call upon them to risk what little they have left? I would spare them the pain of further conflict. Conflict, I say, though that would imply forces set in opposition. If the combined might of three primals could not stay Garlemald's new terror, what meaningful resistance can we offer?
Mistake me not. I do not propose to trade one tyranny for another. I love liberty. But conciliation need not mean oppression.
By the 12, though neither of you cried surrender, your every word betokened it. Not that I deny there is truth in what you say, nor...
As we approached, I would swear I heard talk of surrender. Let the memories rekindle the fire in your heart, for Eorzea has need of it again.
Come what may, we Scions will never give up the fight. And so I bid you stand with us, and together we shall safeguard the future of the realm.
Yourself in the chamber of the Ultima Weapon. Keep your eyes peeled. Gaius could be waiting for you down there. Oh, and don't even think about Don. You're too bloody useful. The interference is getting worse. I don't think the connection will last much.
Tell me, for whom do you fight? Eorzea's unity is forged of falsehoods. Its city-states are built on deceit, and its faith is an instrument of deception. It is not but a cobweb of lies. To believe in Eorzea is to believe in nothing. In Eorzea, the beast tribes often summon gods to fight in their stead. Though your comrades only rarely respond in kind. Which is strange, is it not? 12 otherwise engaged? I was given to understand they were your protectors. If you truly believe them your guardians, why do you not repeat the trick that served you so well in Cartano and call them down? They will answer, so long as you lavish them with crystals and gorge them on ether. Your gods are no different from those of the beasts. Icons, everyone. Except but this, and you will see how Eorzea's faith is bleeding the land dry. Nor is this unknown to your masters, which prompts the question, why do they cling to these false deities? What drives even men of learning, even the great Louis Swan, to grovel at their feet? The answer. Your masters lack the strength to do otherwise. For the world of man to mean anything, man must own the world. To this end, he hath fought ever to raise himself through conflict, to grow rich through conquest. And when the dust of battle settles, it is ever the strong who dictate the fate of the weak. Knowing this, but a single path is open to the impotent ruler, that of false worship. A path which leads to innovation and death. Only a man of power can rightly steer the course of civilization. And in this land of creeping mendacity, that one truth will prove its salvation. Come, champion of Eorzea, face me. Your defeat shall serve as proof of my readiness to rule. It is only right that I should take your realm, but none among you has the power to stop me. Allow me then, hero, to do that which you will not. become a weapon!
Under the protection of the crystal he bears.
So, this is what empowers him.
Beyond mortal limits. If you are to prevail, the hammer of darkness must needs be brought to bear upon the shield of light. And so it shall. For the Ultima weapon is host to a power of which you are as yet ignorant.
Speak plainly, Asir.
The heart of Sabik. It is the weapon's core, an enigma whose surface even the vaunted scholars of ancient Alec failed to scratch. The magic within. Dormant for eons.
Of what matter do you speak?
A spell without parallel. Ultima. I sought the life force of the primals for no other reason but to quicken the core. For the true power of the Ultima weapon lies within its now beating heart.
Lahabrea, what have you done?
No more than is necessary for my god to be reborn.
Damn you, Asir.
The hour is at hand. Behold, but a sliver of my god's power. And from the deepest pit of the seven hells, to the very pinnacle of the heavens, the world shall tremble. Unleash Ultima!
Speak later, Asia. here remains. Come, adventurer. Let us find the answer together.
Unrivaled power. You were entrusted with the ultimate weapon, the ultimate magic. And still, you failed. So much for the glory of man. Imbalance afflicting the planet must be redressed. If it is permitted to worsen, the very laws of existence, both etheric and physical, will be warped beyond all recognition. Know you the root of this corruption? Hydaelyn. Like a parasite, she must be burned out if the planet is to recover. And naught but the return of the one true god will ensure her complete excision. Yet, to pave the way for the Master's return, a chaotic confluence of untold proportions must needs be brought about. And that will necessitate the presence of the Primals. Needless to say, both you and your Scion accomplices cannot be suffered to interfere in this endeavor. You will not leave this place alive. It is past time your flame was extinguished, Drainer of Light.
Ha ha ha! Pierce the shadows. Make thee a blade of light.
So my conquest ends, Cid. In smoke and ashes.
My lady, all Twin Adder units have fallen back to the outer perimeter.
The flames have completed their withdrawal, General.
Admiral, all hands accounted for.
He's still in there.
Cid, has there been no word?
Nothing. Nothing at all.
Damnation!
He's going to make it. I know he is.
Ida is right. We must have faith.
Cid, can they not be evacuated aboard the Enterprise? That adventurer and the Scions are as the Warriors of Light reborn. We cannot abandon them to their fate. Not again.
I wholeheartedly agree, but flying into the midst of that would only add to the fireworks.
There must be something we can do.
Please, Mother Hydaelyn. Please light his way through the darkness.
Look into the light, my child. If thou would see thy companions return safe to thee, reach out to them now.
It's him! I feel his presence!
She calls to us.
I hear her. The voice of Hydaelyn herself.
She speaks of... Strike me down! No wonder he seemed familiar. He's one of the warriors of light! What are you smirking at, Cid? You knew, didn't you?
Oh, you mean our adventurer friend. Did I forget to mention he was one of the warriors of light? Saved Eorzea, you know, twice.
The shroud is lifted. They remember you. There! The 12, we're safe.
Mind your horns there, Manbull.
Mayhap when you mind your manners.
Though the crystal that bound Thancred is no more, I doubt we can say the same of La Habrea. Nevertheless... For now, we must savor what peace we have won, however ephemeral. Do you see, Grandfather? Our first step towards realizing the dream for which you gave your life.
And though the Black Wolf be slain, the rest of the pack remains. Yet no foe need we fear, so long as we stand as one.
So long as the Scion stand for peace.
So long as our champion stands fast. For there exists no adversity over which we may not jointly prevail.
A future united, Has the Warriors of Light united in the Champion?
Now is the time for us to rise as one, bearing all of Eorzea on our shoulders.
5 years ago, Eorzea bore witness to the end of the Sixth Astral Era. Now, the Seventh Umbral Era draws to a close, yet we come together not to glory in its end, but to mark a new beginning.
Let it be writ that on this day, by the light of the crystal, Eorzea ushered in a new era. The Seventh Astral Era is come! And thus is ours a realm reborn!
What is it?
Our code, thou shalt